Okay, so let's talk about sciatica. It's a huge problem affecting thousands of people in the UK and is a term used to describe pain down the back of the leg, otherwise known as pain in the sciatic nerve. The most important thing to understand about sciatica is it's not a diagnosis, it's a symptom, just meaning pain in the sciatic nerve. If you want to resolve your sciatica, it's really important that you find out what is causing that pain. What is pressing on your sciatic nerve and causing it to hurt? So, there's a lot of things that can cause sciatica. Some of them are severe and some of them are really very simple. The more severe causes are things like osteoarthritis, where you get a wear down of the joints and the spine and you get a little bit of bony compression onto the sciatic nerve. Now that's not a great one to have, and you need to take your doctor's advice and your osteopath's advice on how to start reversing and managing osteoarthritis. You can also get it from something called stenosis, spinal stenosis, narrowing of the canals in which the sciatic nerve passes out of. That's also quite a difficult one. Sometimes you do need an operation to resolve that. But the one that I can help you with, the most commonest cause of sciatica in my experience, and maybe it's because it's the patients that I see in my clinic, but it's tight gluteal muscles, tight bum muscles, and another little tiny little muscle right in the center of your bum, either side, called the piriformis. I had a young girl come into my clinic once. She was 23 years old with raging. She called it 10 out of 10 pain, sciatica. Went through her case history, there was no problem. Did all my orthopedic tests, there's nothing wrong. There was no arthritis, there was no disc bulge, which I thought it might be. Nothing going on, but she had rock solid gluteal muscles. On further investigation, I said to her, "What are you doing that is causing these gluteal muscles to tighten up?" Eventually, I discovered that she spent 1 hour, 7 days a week on the bicycle at the gym. She was just tightening up those gluteal muscles so they were becoming rock solid and doing that much stretching, no stretching whatsoever. In about 5% of the population, the sciatic nerve runs actually through the center of the piriformis muscle, but it certainly runs between the gluteals and the piriformis muscles. And if you allow all those muscles to become really, really tight and you never stretch them, you do get leg pain. Now, the great news about this diagnosis is it's so easy to resolve. She's another patient where a couple of treatments of my elbow in her gluteal muscles resolved the problem. Obviously, she had to do her stretches after her cycling to maintain it, but really complete 100% resolution of that sciatic pain. So important for you to get a diagnosis. Unfortunately for you, or fortunately, the only way you're really going to get a diagnosis is to visit an osteopath, someone who specializes in a diagnosis of sciatica. So do that, and then come back to my videos once you have your diagnosis.